Welcome back to our course on Access 2016. In the preceding section, we started looking at relationships. And in order to set up relationships for the Esprit de Tour database, I created a new table containing the types of trip that Esprit de Tour run and a link record, a record that's going to link each trip with the types that that trip has. And in that way, we are building up indirectly a relationship between trip and type using the link record. And in fact, the relations we set up are from trip to trip type and from type to trip type. So in order to do this, we actually set up two relationships. The first relationship we're going to set up is trip to trip type. And the relationship is based on the ID in the trip table. So each record in the trip table, each trip has a unique ID. That's the primary key. And records in the trip type table for that trip will have that same trip ID in the trip ID field in the records in the trip type table. Now, in order to set up the relationship, what I do is to drag ID in the trip table and drop it onto trip ID in the trip type table. And that brings up the Edit Relationships dialog, where I can actually set up the details of the relationship between these two tables. Now, the first thing I do is to make sure that I've got the right tables and the right fields. So on the left, table query trip ID, yep, that's the primary ID of the trip table records, that's fine. And then trip type, trip ID, that is the long integer field that I've set up to match the ID in the trip table. So I've definitely got the right tables and fields selected. The next important decision is, do I enforce referential integrity? Now, on this occasion, I'm going to say yes, but I'm going to explain to you now what referential integrity is. Let's imagine a situation where I've created a trip, and corresponding to that trip, I've, say, created four trip type records. So there's a trip type of beach, and a trip type of family, and a trip type of adventure, and a trip type of escorted. And each of those has the appropriate type, beach, etc., and the trip ID for my selected trip. What would happen if I deleted that trip from the trip table? I'd finish up with four records in the trip type table that had no links at the other end of this relationship. They'd be sort of orphans. So those four records would be referring to a trip that no longer exists. Making sure that that doesn't happen is called enforcing referential integrity. And once I've checked that, if I try to delete a trip, what Access 2016 will do is it will make sure that there are no outstanding trip type records that use that trip. So it won't let me break the database integrity in the way that I just described. Now, there are a couple of other options. Let me talk about one of them. A couple of options down below enforce referential integrity. Cascade delete related records. If I check this option, if I deleted a trip record in the situation I just described, Access would automatically cascade delete the trip type records for that trip. Now, that of course would mean that the database wasn't broken, because those four records would automatically get deleted. So I could enforce referential integrity by checking that box, and that would make sure that nothing got broken by a delete. But for the moment, I'm actually going to uncheck this box, but I am going to say enforce referential integrity. The next piece of information here is the relationship type one to many. And what that means in this situation is that one trip can have many trip types. And that's exactly the situation that I want. So let me create that relationship. And there it is. One trip, many trip types. Now let's set up the second relationship. It's from the type in the type table. Note that although this is a short text field, it is the primary key of the type table, and it goes to type in the trip type table. And that sets up a different relationship. Now we have the same questions. So again, I just check I've got the right fields. So the primary key in the type table is type. The field in the trip type table that I'm setting the relationship up with is type, so that will be a foreign key in the trip type table. I'm once again going to enforce referential integrity, because if I were to delete a type in the type table, I would want to make sure that there weren't any entries in the trip type table that was still using that type. Now once again, I'm not going to check Cascade Delete here. I'm going to leave that unchecked. A consequence of this is that if I did try to delete a type that was in use, Access wouldn't let me do it. I'd have to get rid of all the entries in the trip type table that use that type first before I could delete the type itself. So that's the alternative to Cascade Delete. Now once again, it's a one-to-many relationship, because one entry in the type table, one type, can have many corresponding records in the trip type table. So I click on Create, and I have another one-to-many relationship. The infinity symbol at the end there indicates many. So what we've done here in creating these two relationships is to put in place probably one of the most fundamental building blocks in a relational database. And although in many ways when you first look at relationships, if you've not seen this before, it may all seem rather baffling, when you do understand this, and hopefully you do already, it really is one of the most fundamental aspects of any relational database, certainly a fundamental aspect of Access, which once you've got to grips with it, once you understand what's going on, it really makes an awful lot of other things in relational databases and Access much easier to understand. You will also see why we don't use things like multi-value fields, because multi-value fields can cause all sorts of problems. Now conceptually at first, what we've done here does take a little bit of getting used to, but once you are used to it, you'll find it makes many other things not only much easier but much more flexible as well. Now one very big downside of what we've done so far is that visualizing now the trip database in the light of what we've just done can be a little bit tricky. And in many ways what we really need now is a couple of nice forms to show us how all of this hangs together. You've got a couple of sections to wait before we get to that point though. And the next thing I'm going to do in this section is to actually set some data up to reflect what I've just done. And then in the next section, I'm going to set you an exercise to set up an equivalent set of relationships within the movie rental database. So let me first of all close the relationships window, making sure that I save the changes. And then let me just refresh my memory on the trip table. Open it up. There are my trips. The IDs go from 4 to 15. Then let me open up my type table, the one I created just recently. And now let me open up my trip type table. My trip type table is currently empty. Now, I hope you can cast your mind back to quite a while ago now. I showed you this first example of a trip, the GCA trip that's currently in our trip table. And I mentioned there the type, and there are five values of type for this trip: family, escorted, group, activity, landscapes. And I said we'd skip that time, which we did. Well, now's the time that we're coming back and we're going to set those up. Now back to my trip table. Note that I can switch between these open documents. They're all three tables, but all I need to do is to click on the tab. And the GCA trip has an ID of 4. So all I need to do is go to trip type, type in an ID of 4 and a type of, well, one of them is family. That should be okay. Press the down arrow. Yep, we're fine. Now this is another one for 4. This one is That's fine as well. Let's make a mistake. Let's say I'm going to try to set up for trip ID 3. And that's going to be group. You cannot add a change of record because a related record is required in the table trip. So it knows that there is no trip 3. Of course, there used to be, but there isn't any longer. So that should be 4. And similarly, if I say misspelt the type, it would tell me there was an error there as well. Okay, let me just put in the rest of those. Now at this point, you're probably looking at that and thinking, my goodness, that is a really slow way of setting all of this up. And I think anybody who doesn't think that's a slow way of setting things up must be much more patient than I am. Because of course, in the longer term, we're certainly not going to be setting up this information like that. The reason that I'm doing it like this here is just to emphasize exactly what happens with these relationships and these link records. Note the ID of the trip type records, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We will rarely, if ever, use those, but they're there to uniquely identify trip type records. And it may be that at some point later on we may need those IDs. What's important is the trip ID. So these trip type records are all for trip 4. And there are 5 of them, so we know that trip 4 has 5 types associated with it. So let's see referential integrity at work, shall we? Let's go to our trip table. Let's go to trip 4. Right click, delete record. Dangerous, this. The record cannot be deleted or changed because the table trip type includes related records. So I cannot delete that until I get rid of the trip type records. If I had enabled Cascade Delete, it would let me do it, but I haven't, so it won't. Now, as I said just now, I realise that this is a pretty manual way of doing a job like this, and you're maybe thinking of databases with thousands of records on them and thinking, my goodness, am I going to sit down and type all that in? And the answer, of course, is no, and you almost certainly wouldn't expect your users to. So we do need to start to use forms to make all this a lot easier, quicker and safer. But the first thing we're going to do in the next section is you are going to do an exercise similar to what's been covered in this section and the preceding one, but you're going to set up some relationships in the movie rental database. That's what we're covering next. I'll see you then.
Hi, I'm Molly. Thanks for watching. If you would like to see similar videos, click the subscribe button on the right. I'll see you next week with additional videos.